point.
Here I am about to put your Bobby Bland song down on tape, and I thought I would just have a little word with you about it before I got started. First of all, as we know, the basis of the Bobby Bland song is the intricate and interesting horn parts. So I think before we do anything else, I shall lay down the bare bones for the horn parts for you. And you will obviously want to do other things to the horns, but you will have the basic idea of them down there. Too. Ready to have verses pulled in and out of it at your discretion. Do whatever you like. You can, you know, it's quite loose at the moment, but there is that basic foundation of the song down there for you. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you have lots of fun with it, and I hope to hear it and, in fact, be on it also. And jolly good luck to you. See you and talk to you very shortly. Lots of love to all from your own Snakefinger. Lots of love to all from your own Snakefinger.
Version. And we started the beginning of the show out with the new Sham 6945, The Kids Are United. And we're going to do part two of that later. Right now, it's the first guest is Snakefinger. He's with us in the studio tonight. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome.
How's it going?
All right. Welcome to San Francisco.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Applause in the background.
A few rubbish.
Really? You've been jumping up around L.A. last weekend down there doing some promo for your single, which
yep.
is great, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
On Ralph
it.
Records.
Yep.
Yes, we're going to be hearing that, but did you want to say something, Howie?
I wanted to say that the single is number one in the new wave chart in Sam's this week.
Yeah, the brand new list that just came out, number
we
one.
We at Ralph are very pleased and proud to have this number one new wave single. We'd like to thank all our fans everywhere in the world, particularly in Japan and Australia.
Very
Bruce,
strong over
thank
there.
Thank you, Bruce. And Sheila, thank you too.
They can hear you all the way.
I know.
They're strong
friends.
Underground.
They've got big ears too.
Well, in case people who don't know what you sound like, before we talk to you a little bit more, I think we should go into the A-side, which is The Spot, and give them an earful.
Number one song, anyone?
Wow, all right. I love it. You are on Ralph Records, which we know is the home of the residents.
Yeah, that is correct. I'm with them.
You want to tell the story of how you got connected with it? What's the label?
Certainly, yeah.
The anonymous residents?
Well, it all started when I went on holiday to Bavaria. I was going on a cycling holiday of some of the mountains around there, you see, at the time. And I met this strange guy in the forest one day who was recording bird noises. He thought that Mahler's music was based on them, you see. So we got together and went around recording noises that we heard all around and generally calling them music. And then on our way to Munich, we heard these tapes that were meant to be from these people from California who were meant to be on a similar sort of level to what we were doing. So as I was thinking of going over there anyway, we just shot over and the next thing you know, we were creating the San Mateo sound together. Reorganizing musical.
What year was that? How long ago?
That was in 70. I hear my record company manager from behind prompting me with the correct date being 71. 1971 was when we finally got over here.
The residents have performed very few times, but you played with them once at the Long Branch, is that correct?
Yeah.
So there's a few people, I'm sure, who remember the rather rip birthday party that happened at the Long Branch, a rare residence appearance.
That was exactly when it all happened.
I remember you were up on top of a kind of a platform, and you were rocking back and forth. You looked like Big Bird.
That's right. I was dressed up as a giant avocado at the time. And I was on a pair of ski boots that were nailed to the floor, so I could move at any angle I wanted to, basically.
I loved it. It was great. Yes, so was the record, and I think we should go back and hear side two of it.
Okay, I could bear that.
All right, this is the Smelly Tongues.
All right, sounds great there, Cosmo.
Oh yeah, that was from the Duckstab Residence EP that Snakefinger plays violin on.
Right? Yeah, that's right, it was violin on that one.
A laughing violin.
Hilarious, I would say. So was some other.
We didn't give your background as far as some of the people you've played with, I just remembered. You should do some credentials.
Played with the old Chilly Willies back in England.
A great pub band.
Yeah, all right.
You call the background there.
Mr. Rubbish doesn't stop rolling these big joints. I'm not going to be able to play anything.
You're not allowed to say that on the radio.
Oh, I'm sorry. I retract that last statement.
You can say rubbish on the radio.
No rubbish, right?
No rubbish, all right. And let's see, the old Nick Lowe's and the drummer from the old Willies is playing for Elvis Costello now, and they're making millions of bucks with Jake Cove productions all over the world. Wonderful to see.
That's all right. It's alternative music. That's always what I am going for anyway.
Oh, right. Yeah, definitely.
Well, if people want to meet you, they can see you tomorrow over at Aquarius Records, which is a store I know pretty well.
Definitely. But wonderful record store. One of the grooviest, if not the grooviest in town.
You'll be there at 2 o'clock.
I will be there at 2 o'clock.
That's at 595 Castro Street in San Francisco. And then later on, you'll be at... Thank you.
12 minuten geworden en je luistert naar een speciale uitzending van het programma Beautiful Extremes. En we hebben nog steeds in de studio Snakefinger en Mr. Hardy Fox, de manager van The Residents, de manager van Cryptic Corporation. So this is one of the other things The Residents recorded after their worldwide tour.
Yes.
And Snakefinger isn't on it.
No, he's been gone too much.
Yes, I've been very busy touring and finishing off my own record, and the residents tell me that I have a lot of work to catch up on when I get back. When I used to be in England after the first time I met the residents, they just send me blank tape to record anything on, and I just record anything on it, and then they'd use the blank tape.
So now it's the other way around. They fill the tape and they send it over.
That's
so,
right.
But after touring with the residents, you worked on your own LP?
Yes, that's right. We both got back from Australia and New Zealand, and in between Australia and New Zealand and coming to Europe, the residents went back and they finished up their LP, and I went back and finished up my LP.
Yeah, and now you are touring again. So.
No,
you have a busy life touring.
That's right, I'm rather busy being out and about, but I mean, It's rather wonderful considering that we're still getting away with it after all this time.
And is this only a European tour or is this a world Snakefinger tour?
Well, we did 2 months in America just before this.
Oh.
And we're going to Australia in November.
Again?
Yes, yeah. So it's kind of following in the resident's footsteps, you might say.
So a lot of people don't know, but you're English.
Yes, that's right.
Do you still have the idea that you're living in England, or?
No, I don't.